What would you do if you were sunbathing in your backyard pool on a bright day when something unexpected happened? The pool begins to boil and foam. The next thing you know, the entire area in front of you is covered in steam. Light and penetrating radiation burn your skin as a shockwave blows away the burning remains of your body. Only the burnt pool walls survive. No, a thunderstorm did not occur. No, you did not get struck by lightning. Nothing extraordinary actually happened. Merely a small entity hitting a nearby object at the speed of light. I know I've talked about something similar in a previous video, but today, we're going to look at a terrifyingly more realistic scenario. So, are you up for a new experiment? If that's the case, then let's get this started. I'll utilize 99.999999% of the speed of light for this study, considering the fact that there's nothing that can be as fast as the speed of light. Imagine a needle falling into the ocean. Don't worry, nothing would happen if it landed in the middle of an uninhabited aquatic area. However, if the needle falls about 6 miles from the shore, this is where some concerning issues begin. Let's say that the situation happened and you're a surfer who gets on a board and paddles out. As the needle falls to the ocean, a blinding flash follows, followed by a wave which is the size of a 6-story home. It's difficult for you to understand where the tsunami originated from since the sun is so bright outside. Then, the wave engulfs you. The possibility of surviving are quite low at this rate. However, because the world's oceans encompass 70% of the Earth's surface, such a needle is considerably more likely to fall far from the human habitat. The small needle would have the energy of 100 tons of TNT, which is the same energy contained in the 6 bombs detonated on Hiroshima, if it moved at close to the speed of light. The ocean could just vanish through evaporation as a result of such a strong collision. Maybe not all of it, but around 2 million tons at least. If the stream reached a height of 6 miles in the troposphere, tropical rains would fall. Stormy streams of water would flood the streets. People and cars would be racing to save themselves. Above all this, there is a potential of falling trees and damaging electrical lines. Climate change would be less noticeable if the needle fell into the ocean and the vapor penetrated the stratosphere. However, the effect would be much greater. Due to the excessive water vapor, there could be an uncontrolled greenhouse effect. The greenhouse effect, as we all know, would gradually heat up the world at an intense level until the oceans boiled. This would turn the Earth into a similar version of Venus, where there is no life. If 2 million tons of water vapor reach the mesosphere, where the temperature is negative 176 to negative 194 degrees, the same amount of water would fall on the planet as a hailstorm. The results would be quite unexpected. The hailstorm may last for hours to several days. Then an ice flood may happen afterward. With this, we can say that the evaporated ocean water would just return to us in its same form, drowning everything in its path. But what if the needle fell in one of the world's most deadly spots, Lake Karachi? Radioactive waste has been kept in Lake Karachi since 1951, and since then, around 150 million curies of radioactive material have been found. The lake was completely closed off with concrete in 2015. However, going to the beach with friends for a picnic is still dangerous because standing on the beach for 15 minutes could expose you to a fatal dose of radioactive radiation, equivalent to 600 X-rays. Imagine a needle hitting Lake Karachi at nearly the speed of light. What do you think will happen? If you've made it this far into the video, you're clearly enjoying it. Give it a like and subscribe so you don't miss anything. And let us know what you think in the comments section. If the needle reached Lake Karachi at near light speed, it would only take nanoseconds to break the concrete covering. This means all of the radioactive dust and debris that was concealed by the concrete would be dispersed within a 125-mile radius. Then there would be a plume of vapor in the form of a nuclear mushroom, and the scent of rotten eggs could be smelled for hundreds of miles. If the needle landed near Yellowstone National Park's geysers at near light speed, all 3,000 subsurface springs, including the world's largest geyser steamboat, would instantaneously vaporize. The carbon dioxide levels would cause death within 30 to 60 minutes. All of this contributes to the notorious and toxic hydrogen sulfide. You might be thinking right now, that needles don't really fly in space, and if that a tiny space object moved at near-light speed, it would never hit planet Earth. Well, that might be true. Micro and nanoparticles in space burn up instantly once they reach the upper atmosphere of our planet. This experiment may appear to you now as pure science fiction, but believe me, such an object may still possibly fall on us. However, not from space. The Large Hadron Collider's testing was finally completed in Geneva, Switzerland in 2008. Protons swirl concurrently clockwise and counterclockwise inside the Hadron Collider, striking virtually at the speed of light. All that remains is to increase the value by one unit. Protons would have to accelerate by only 9.8 feet per second to reach the speed of light. The Hadron Collider uses 180 megawatts of electricity every hour, the equivalent of energy used by a city with 500,000 people. What would happen if an accident occurred within it? There are numerous myths about the massive Hadron Collider. Many people believe that when high-energy particles combine, a black hole is possibly generated, which may engulf our entire planet and lead to the end of the world. If there was a control system malfunction in the collider and a superpowered magnetic funnel, the size of a transport tornado would surge into space. The vortex's base diameter would be 16 miles, while the top would engulf the entire sky for hundreds of miles. The flow of tiny particles from space would be tightened and increased by the electromagnetic field, rushing directly to the collider's center. The particles would burn up in the atmosphere. Although we can witness the comet's lovely flying tail, a nuclear explosion would follow, destroying half of Switzerland in its wake. Everything would be completely destroyed, even the most beautiful places in Europe. One last chance for survival of Swiss citizens would be a protective screen against microparticles. But there is one drawback. A disturbance in the Earth's magnetic field at Lake Geneva would create a massive ozone hole, allowing cold air from the mesosphere to enter the Earth's surface. Because of this, the ice age would return in a matter of days, and the entire world might freeze in a matter of weeks. With this, hemoglobin would stop supplying oxygen to organs and tissues if the body temperature reached 46 degrees Fahrenheit. Tissues would be deprived of oxygen and nutrition, resulting in widespread cell death. Humanity's odds of survival would be quite slim. However, all of this is fiction that is still far from reality. This is still an experiment only backed up by science. Still, we'd be living in a post-apocalyptic world where no one could leave the house without a gas mask, and everyone would be living in bomb shelters. Only exceptional unity could save humanity. There would be no time for disagreements and conflict, and everybody would be busy helping each other. Sounds quite nice, right? However, in terms of bomb shelters, did you know that Switzerland has the most nuclear bomb shelters in the world? For instance, they say that there is a bomb shelter in every residential building in Switzerland. That means there could be 300,000 bomb shelters, which can hold 8.5 million people, or 114% of the population. Take note that this is in Switzerland, a country that has never been involved in armaments races or any world conflicts. Is this really just a coincidence? Something not based on some conspiracy? Well, I don't seem to believe it. What about you? What are your thoughts on the risks of the Hadron Collider? If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching Ponder This.